There are four different forms of plasmid DNA we learn about, and understanding the characteristics and differences of each of these can be a bit of a challenge, especially when you're new to the topic, or you don't deal with this stuff very often, or you're transitioning from another discipline into some of these areas of biology. So in today's video, I'm breaking down the four different forms of plasmid DNA, and these include supercoiled, relaxed, linear, and multimeric plasmid DNA. What makes this even more confusing is sometimes there are different words used to describe each one of these. So how about we get into it with supercoiled being our first plasmid form. Supercoiled DNA is also known as covalently closed circular DNA. So imagine we have a rubber band and it's twisted up on itself multiple times. Hopefully you can see that. This is the most compact form of plasmid DNA commonly found in living bacterial cells. In this natural state, supercoiled DNA is very space efficient. Its compact structure allows it to take up less space and migrate quickly during gel electrophoresis. Next up is relaxed or nicked circular DNA. This form occurs when one DNA strand is nicked, often by UV radiation or nucleases, causing the plasmid to lose its tight twist and become more relaxed. That nick releases a lot of tightness. Relaxed DNA occupies more space and moves slower during gel electrophoresis due to its less compact structure. It's often used in experiments to study DNA repair mechanisms, DNA replication, and DNA transcription. Our third plasmid form is linear DNA, also known as a linear monomer, which results from the cleavage of both DNA strands by restriction endonucleases. Picture a rubber band being cut straight through, turning it into a straight line. And since it's double-stranded, both sides would be cut. Linear DNA moves at an intermediate speed during gel electrophoresis, so between supercoiled and relaxed forms. It's frequently used in molecular cloning and genetic engineering because it's fairly easy to manipulate. However, it is more susceptible to degradation by nucleases. Finally, our last plasmid form is the multimeric form, which is also sometimes called a concatemer, open circle dimer, or concatenated plasmid. These occur when plasmids link together end-to-end, forming long chains or dimers. These forms are significantly larger than single plasmid forms, and they move very slowly in a gel. Their complexity can complicate DNA analyses and experiments due to their size and difficulty in separation. Understanding these different forms of plasmid DNA is crucial for various biological and genetic research applications. Each form has unique characteristics that make it suitable for specific scientific purposes. We also have additional resources on the topic, including how to distinguish these types of plasmids on a gel.